हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव स्टडीड द कांसेप्ट ऑफ कोशी सीक्वेंस। कोशी सीक्वेंस इज नथिंग बट द सीक्वेंस ऑफ रियल नंबर्स हुज टर्म्स बिकम्स वेरी क्लोज टू ईच अदर आफ्टर वेरी लार्ज यंग। वी हैव प्रूव दैट एवरी कोशी सीक्वेंस, एवरी कॉन्वर्जेंट सीक्वेंस इज कोशी, कोशी सीक्वेंस इज बाउंडेड, देन एवरी कोशी सीक्वेंस इज ऑल्सो कॉन्वर्जेंट। By using the result, a sequence is convergent if and only if lim sup of Sn is equal to lim sup of Sn. So by using this sufficient condition, we have proved it. In this session, we'll prove one application of convergent sequence, which is nothing but nested interval theorem for closed and bounded intervals in set of real numbers. So what is the nested interval theorem? If In is equal to closed bounded interval a n to b n such that I1 contain, I2 contain, I3 contain dot dot etc. and length of I n is equal to length limit of b n minus a, limit n tends to infinity of length of I n is equal to limit b n minus a n is zero, then intersection of I n contain precisely single point, one point. So by one, I n plus one is a subset of, I n plus one is a m plus one to b m plus one is subset of I n equal to a m b n for every n. Means a m plus one must be less equal in a m plus one and b m plus one lies in I n. Means a n is less equal a m plus one, less equal b m plus one, less equal b m for every n. What this implies is n is non-decreasing, means it is increasing sequence, say, and bn is non-increasing sequence of real numbers from I1, closed and bounded interval I1, bounded interval I1 is equal to a1 to b1. Therefore, n and bn, so n is increasing sequence which is bounded above by b1 and bn is non-increasing means decreasing sequence which is bounded below by a1. So, n, bn are monotone bounded sequences. Monotone bounded sequences. And we know that increasing bounded above sequence is convergent, decreasing bounded below sequence is convergent. Therefore, A and B n are convergent sequences. And B n n equal to 1 to infinity are convergent sequences. So suppose limit n tends to infinity of A n is equal to A. Suppose limit n tends to infinity of an is equal to a and limit n tends to infinity of bn is equal to b, then we know that increasing sequence n is increasing and all n's are less equal limit of bn. Okay, so by 3, AM's is less equal BN for all M, for all MN, implies limit of AN must be less equal for any MN is less equal limit BN, and therefore A is less equal B, A less equal B. Moreover, AN is less equal A, less equal B, less equal BN for all N implies A comma B belongs to IN for every N. A is goes on increasing and n converges to A. Okay. Here n is less equal A for all n and bn goes on decreasing, b is less equal bn for all n, right? So AB belongs to IN for every n and therefore A comma B belongs to intersection of IN, n equal to 1 to infinity. Now A and B, now mod of or B minus A is less equal length of IN is equal to BN minus AN, which tends to 0 as n tends to infinity. Implies B minus A must be 0. Therefore, B minus A is equal to 0. Therefore, B is equal to A. Therefore, B is equal to A. Thus, intersection of IN contain at least one point. Okay. Now, if X belongs to intersection one point A, X belongs to intersection of IN, then X and A belongs to IN for every n. Therefore, mod of X minus A less equal length of IN is equal to again BN minus AN, which tends to 0 as n tends to infinity. And therefore, mod X minus A must be 0. And therefore, X is equal to A. And therefore, intersection of IN contain precisely one point. So thus, nested interval theorem is proved. Now, if I omit the condition close intervals from this theorem, then the result is not true. Okay. So, example, give example of bounded intervals, ions such that I1 contain, I2 contain, dot dot, etc. And limit of length of IN is equal to 0. But intersection of IN contain no point. If you take the example, for every n belongs to n, IN is equal to open interval 0 to 1 by n, or intervals such that I1 contain, I2 contain, I3 contain, and so on, and length of IN is equal to 1 by n tends to 0 as n tends to infinity. Now, intersection of IN, if I take intersection of I1, I2, is nothing but limit of n tends to infinity of 0 to 1 by n, which is open interval 0 to 0, which is phi set. As n goes to infinity, there is no any real number which lies between 0 and 0, Okay. Thus, intersection of IN contain no point. Contain no point. Okay. We'll take one more good application of Cauchy theorem. So take the example. So let S and V sequence of real numbers. S and V, or we'll take AN. AN be sequence of real numbers. And SN is equal to A1 plus A2 plus AN. TN is equal to mod A1 plus mod A2 plus dot dot up to mod AN for every N. For every N. Prove that if SN is Cauchy sequence, is Cauchy sequence, then your TN if TN is Cauchy sequence, then SN is Cauchy sequence. Cauchy sequence. Okay. So solution. What is given here? Okay. So here N is a real sequence. SN is equal to A1 plus A2 plus dot dot up to AN. TN is equal to mod A1 plus mod A2 plus dot dot up to mod AN for every N. Now since TN is Cauchy sequence, therefore, for given epsilon greater than 0, there exists positive integer n0, such that mod of Tn minus Tm is less than epsilon for any n greater equal m greater equal n0. For any n m greater equal n0, among n and m, we'll assume that n is greater than m or n equal to m. Then mod of summation of ak, this implies k equal to m plus 1 to n is less than epsilon for n greater equal m greater equal n naught, and therefore summation of mod ak k equal to m plus 1 n. Here I am assuming n is greater than m, means in Tn, which is the sum of first n terms, Tm is sum of first m terms, so first m terms will get cancelled, so this difference gives us remaining n minus m terms, remaining first mod a1 mod a2 up to mod am, that terms will get cancelled in the difference. And so we'll get this, which is less than epsilon for nm greater equal n0. Now मॉड ऑफ एस एन माइनस एस एम अगेन इज इक्वल टू, इफ आई टेक दिस दिस अगेन समीशन ऑफ ए के इक्वल टू एम प्लस वन टू एन. ओके एंड दिस इज लेस इक्वल समीशन ऑफ मॉड ए के इक्वल टू एम प्लस वन टू एन बाय ट्रायंगल इनइक्वालिटी. दिस इज लेस देन एप्सिलॉन फॉर एन ग्रेटर इक्वल एम ग्रेटर इक्वल एन नॉट बाय वन बाय वन. दस फॉर गिवन एप्सिलॉन ग्रेटर देन जीरो दस फॉर गिवन एप्सिलॉन ग्रेटर देन जीरो देयर एग्जिस्ट पॉजिटिव इंटीजर एन नॉट such that mod of Sn minus Sm is less than epsilon for any nm greater equal n naught and therefore Sn is Cauchy sequence. So our next chapter is series of real numbers. And this is the Cauchy's criterion for convergence of series of real numbers. Convergence of series of real number. So thus, in real sequence topic, we have studied definition of sequence, then subsequence, concept of monotone sequence, bounded above, bounded below sequences, operations on convergent sequences, divergent sequence, diverging to infinity, diverging to minus infinity, oscillatory sequence, then operations on divergent sequences, right? And then we talk about the limb sublimin of the sequence, and at the end we have studied concept of the Cauchy sequence. So hereby we have completed the part of real sequence for the syllabi of Savitribai Phule Pune University for TYBSC semester 5. Our next topic will be series of real numbers. Till we have covered two chapters, sets and function, and second one is sequence of real numbers. Go through all lectures one by one, listen lecture carefully, write down the notes. I tried on my level best to give the complete solutions of examples as well as complete proofs of the theorems in this online teaching due to the lockdown period. I again request all students go through lecture sessions carefully and like the lectures so that I'll get energy to make the remaining lectures which will be helpful for you and other students also. So thanks for listening lecture carefully. Bye-bye.